And somebody tell me that if you're ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, you are in a bad place. But I must acknowledge that my standing before you is by no other man but the man Christ Jesus. Because you see, I was born in sin, and I was shaped in iniquity. So therefore, my desire is always to do something wrong. But God,
amen.
Oh, in his mercy,
amen,
brought me out of darkness into this marvelous light.
Amen.
And I'm walking with a rejoicing in my step. Because when I look back and see how stupid I was, walking without protection,
amen,
I realize that I've been, by grace, come to a place where God is protecting me. So the psalmist says, whatever comes my way,
amen,
I learned to trust in Jesus.
Amen.
I learned to trust in God.
Amen.
But the Lord also let us know that you must give honor where honor is due.
Amen.
And I'm in this company of great people, amen, under the leadership of a great man who has,
amen,
come to love as a brother,
yes,
because of his warmth and his Christ-likeness.
Amen.
Pastor Tommy, you and your family, God bless you.
Amen.
And I have a brother here, Pastor Billy.
Amen.
At one point, Pastor Billy says he was a Studio 54, huh? We were all talking. I was there, brother. You never know. But look where he brought us from.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus. I don't have to worry when I leave here if I got pulled over and they give me a breathalyzer test. Because I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm not filled with that old booze that I used to drink. When I leave the club, I have to wonder, when I see a light flashing, where will I be in a few minutes? But now when I get pulled over, if I get pulled over, I can look at whoever pulled me over and says, the only thing you're going to find in me is Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So I greet you all. I've seen familiar faces already. But for the sake of time, I am just going to do this. I greet you all in the mighty name of,
amen,
Jesus.
Amen.
Because you see, we can't spend too much time in the pulpit doing this small talk, so to speak. Because the time,
it's our time.
It's,
amen.
The time is short.
Yes.
So therefore, we can't spend a whole lot of time dealing with self.
Yeah.
Because self is just trouble.
Yeah.
But oh, when I walk with the Lord, and the light of his word, what a hope.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Did I leave my glass down here? I am getting seasoned, so my vision. Notice I didn't say I'm getting old. Season. So therefore, there are things that are added and things that are taken away.
Amen.
I'm going to talk to you this morning briefly from the book, two books, as a matter of fact. I'm coming from the scripture is Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 1, one verse. And the next one is from 1 Timothy 6 and 12. By the way, I need to go home when I leave here. And he says, he's a human guy. I need to go home when I leave here. And I need to have my meal. And I did not acknowledge my wife. That has put up with me and my foolishness for over 38 years.
Yes.
That's my high school teacher. And my brother, Minister Dixon, came all the way from Brooklyn to be with me surprisingly. He just said, We were in fellowship last night over with his congregation, and he said, I'm coming with him today.
Amen.
And I'm like, whoa, somebody cares about me. Huh?
Yes.
But the word of God says this morning, from Ecclesiastic, verse 1, and from 1 Timothy 6 and 12. I'm going to just read that to you, and we're going to have a little talk with Jesus. Just for a little while. Ecclesiastic chapter 12 and verse 13 says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandment, for this is man's all. I'm reading from the New King James Version. And from whatever version you're reading from, you'll find that it is agreeing with the King James Version is saying. Let me go quickly to the book of Timothy, 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 12. Well, I'm going to read 13 because I think this blends well with what I'm about to say to you. Here's what it says. Fight the good fight of faith.
Hallelujah.
Lay hold.
Eternal life.
To what?
Eternal life.
To which you were also called and have confessed the good confession in the presence of many witnesses.
Hallelujah.
I urge you in the sight of God. Who gives life to all things, and before Christ, who witnessed the good confession before Pontius Pilate. Father God, we come this morning, your people that are sitting under the sound of my voice, and I don't understand why you use and choose me this morning. But one thing I know for sure, you are God, all by yourself. And whatever your plan is for any man's life, we can't resist it. So the ears that we hear this morning, let it be from you and not from myself. So I'm asking you, God, to diminish me, oh God. This is just a lump of clay that you breathe in one day, and I still need you to leave me and let me fall. God, let the words of my mouth, God,
and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, our strength and redeemer.
You're my redeemer.
Amen.
Let the word redeem somebody this morning.
Quicken them with your word this morning, Lord. Quicken with your word this morning, Lord. Quicken. Hallelujah.
Should put a title, and this scripture this morning that I've read and put a label on it, according to man, what I would call, he said it is, it's restoring a culture of righteousness in an immoral, wicked world. Restoring a culture of righteousness in an immoral,
wicked world.
A wicked world. Culture. And I do a brief study on culture. And culture is the sum of attitude, customs, and beliefs that distinguish one group of people from another. Are we Christians today? Are we a unique and called out people? Are we trying to blend in with the world? If you're trying to blend in with the world, you need to check your Christian walk.
Amen.
Because I'm telling you, this world is not for us.
Hallelujah.
We're just passing through.
Yes.
And while we're passing through, God called on all of us that are called on his name to make a difference.
Yes.
We can walk like everybody walks.
No.
We can't talk like everybody talks.
Jesus!
We can't go where everybody Christian trait that will change the culture of this wicked world. Too many of us are proud and arrogant and acting as if we're saved and on our way to heaven and we're okay. I'm here to let you know this morning that if you're going to heaven by yourself, you're on a wrong journey. The Lord says, go ye to all the world and preach the gospel. He did not call upon the man and woman who worship another God to preach the gospel. The gospel is from Christ to the world. The gospel is from Christ to all of us. Our responsibility in his great commission before his ascension, he said, I am gone to prepare a place for you. And when I go, I will come again to receive you into my kingdom. Amen. Now, who is he going to receive? He's going to receive those that have the Lord Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. You and I are the conduit by which God is going to change the world. I have yet to hear a cow preaching. I have yet to hear my pretty eyes talking. I have yet to hear my car that I love so much giving somebody a word of encouragement. It takes you and I and all of us to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. How are we going to change the culture? How are we going to bring righteous culture into the world? Here's what the Bible says, which no other book that is considered religious said. The Bible says, if my people that are called by my name will humble themselves and pray
and fall. Seek my face. Seek my face. Seek my face.
Church folks, we need to pray more.
Yes.
We need to trust God more. We're relying on our intellect. When God says, all I need from you is to proclaim my name. Seek my face. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus.
Glory to God.
So when we walk around and tell folks how educated I am, nothing wrong with education. We must let them know it's by the grace of God.
Right.
We got to put everything to God in prayer.
Yes.
And even when I am doing my job, I need to let somebody know I am not so good. It's a good God that I serve.
Yes, yes.
Changing the culture. How do we restore that culture? Once upon a time, you hear the whole preaching segment. Some of them will argue. And they will tell you, God, when I don't understand, my father was a preacher. And he'll tell me, son, I used to be the one of them, Pastor Tamba, that would approach my daddy, me and my sinful self. And I would stop. I said, Daddy, how God? How God? How God? And I keep asking, I have all of these questions. My father couldn't read well, second grade education. But he said to me, son, I don't know, but I know God.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
I don't know, but I know Jesus.
Yes.
You don't have to have all the answers.
Yes.
You only need one.
Amen.
You only need Jesus.
Yes.
And that's all you need. Hey, you just don't, you don't have to be a theologian. You have to be a Christian.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah. Yes.
Listen, way back before God came in the flesh and dwelt among us, in the book of Corinthians, in the book of Chronicles, chapter 7, verse 14, that's where he said to me, if my people, that's not them. And you know, the younger generation, that's me. We have a tendency to get so deep that we confuse ourselves. We have a tendency to get so deep that the common man don't understand us. You ever notice? There are some of us who are saved, but we can't even say good morning.
Glory.
But I'm here to tell you something. Don't be surprised. Amen. The enemy is going to cultivate right in your church.
Yes. Arabasha.
Right. Right
in the name of Jesus.
They sit in the front.
Yes.
And sometimes they hide in the crowd.
Yes. Yes.
You are the agent of change.
Yes. Yes.
That governments take by law of the church. We are here like many times since it happened, right? Right? But let me ask you a question. When the government take the Bible, what did you do in your home? I'm here to tell you that your children emulate you.
Yes.
They emulate the government.
Yes.
More than they emulate the teacher.
That's right.
I'm here to prove that to you.
Bless your name.
But here's what the word of God says. Back then, when it was not so fashionable, he says, write it
on the tables of your heart.
Therefore, when they go to school, it's not the rap part of the metal music that is taking control of them.
Right.
It's the word of God.
Yes.
When the teacher hears it, let me tell you something. A young lady at my church, I'm going to cut it out. A young lady at my church started in college, Pastor Vinny, and the teacher. Teacher, have her to write a paper about life. And she said, I want you to write on the significance of evolution. Because man was not created like they say. You know they when they're talking.
Right.
Don't look at yourself. When we hear certain language, they're talking about you.
Amen.
Right. They're just created a nice way.
Yes.
Well, this young lady wrote her paper. When she wrote her paper, she said, mankind began in the Garden of Eden, created by God, breathed the breath of life in us. But because of sin, I'm paraphrasing now, we have separated ourselves. From our existence.
Yes.
Right.
By putting more emphasis and evolution. But I'm not from no monkey.
Amen.
Stop compromising.
Yes.
And let folks know, for God I live.
And for God I die. Oh.
Let folks know, it's not me so good. It's a good God.
Amen.
Let folks know that I walk by faith.
And not by sight.
Obstacle.
Amen.
Because when some of us get what we pray for.
Hallelujah.
We forget to bless the blesser.
Amen.
Some of us forget what we pray for. We forget to tell the Lord thank you.
Amen.
But we start to tell folks, Brother Vinny, look, I just did this, and I just did that. So therefore, we know, many children, those that do not know the Lord, even them, will gravitate to the culture of selfishness.
Yes.
Instead of giving God the thanks and praise he deserves. The conclusion of the whole matter, and when I leave, Pastor, I'll ask you, put me to the side and tell me if I'm wrong. When he says the conclusion of the whole matter is to serve God, that's what the people who believe.
Yes.
In God. Am I wrong, Pastor?
No.
The conclusion of the whole matter is to serve God.
That's it.
Then Brother Paul picked it up over in Timothy. And then he says, Christians,
fight the good
fight.
The good fight of a
good fight.
Hallelujah.
Listen to me. Good fight.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. Anything you get while you're here in this mortal flesh is just for a moment.
Amen.
It's just for a little while. Then all this is just kindled from fire. What you get is only what you get from God will last.
Yes.
Fight. Paul says to Timothy, it's a good fight. The Bible let us know that in the metaphor of you, he said you must put on
the whole
arm, the breastplate of righteousness.
That means
you have to be ready for battle.
Yes.
When you leave here today and you go out into this sinful, wicked world, you better have on
the full armor.
The full armor
of God.
And when you put on the full armor of God, doesn't mean you have to be slapping folks over with a whole lot of yin yang. That's what they call it nowadays.